My, what a nice warm couple of days it's been, everyone. We actually reached where I was. I was in a Vancouver suburb in Maple Ridge and Langley, BC today, and we reached 28 degrees. It got a lot hotter in a lot of areas in BC, but 28 degrees for April is amazing. Just to put it in perspective, it was also 28 degrees today at the exact same time. This afternoon, when I checked temperatures, it was 28 degrees here. It was 28 degrees in Las Vegas, Nevada. And actually, we were 5 degrees warmer than it was way down in Miami, Florida. Florida was, it was only 23 degrees in Miami. I mean, 23 degrees is warm. It's beach weather. Yeah, no problem. And here, it was 28, and this is the scene down at Kitts Beach in Vancouver today. Lots of people are out getting their tan on. And of course, over on another beach in Vancouver, at Sunset Beach next to downtown, it was the 420 rally. So lots and lots and lots of smoke over the city today. I don't exactly know why they do these rallies and protests anymore, or why they're doing it, because the federal government announced today, of all days, on 420, that next year pot will be legal nationwide. So I don't know why they're so-called protesting anymore. I mean, I used to always joke about this, man. What are potheads gonna do when they finally legalize marijuana? Because they're gonna have nothing to do anymore, because all they do is protest all the time. But hey, I'm not knocking pot smokers. I don't smoke pot, but if that's your thing, then good for you. Go ahead and smoke it. I don't care. To each their own, right? Anyways, let's get on to this. I get this question quite often. It's about my choice of vehicles. I'll just read you an email I got on the 18th, just a couple of days ago. Hi Justin, I'm a subscriber of your YouTube channel and enjoying your videos. I just got a new RV, a 2015 Winnebago View on the Sprinter chassis, and I traded in a 2003 Fleetwood Tioga 24-foot. 2003 is like brand new with RVs. I don't know why you'd want to trade it in, but okay. I'm very happy with my new RV with gas mileage and ride. The MB chassis is so much better in handling and comfort with outstanding miles per gallon. Why don't you like MB Sprinter-based RVs? Is there a reason why you only like North American-made chassis? I'm really curious why. And this is from Jay in Mill Creek, Washington, USA. Jay, I've gone over this a few times. Actually, it's funny that you mentioned your trade-in there. I'm going to assume that your Tioga was a Ford or a Chevy chassis. I had a viewer on my Facebook page, facebook.com/justincredibletv, who just did the exact opposite. They traded in their, or traded up, they said, they thought, their, I think it was a 2004, it was four, five, or six. Ford base Class C RV for a Sprinter base Class C RV, and immediately regretted their decision and then traded back and got another Ford based RV. And there's lots of reasons people prefer the North American chassis, and I'm one of them. And I've said this before in my videos, and I'll say it again. Simplicity is a good thing. I prefer older vehicles. This one is way too new for me. 2004 is just, yes, I could have bought an older one, but it was the floor plan. I was more concerned with the house portion of it, and I didn't really care if the front cab was a 2004 or a 1974. It was what I wanted back here. But I do prefer the North American chassis. When it comes to the Class Bs, obviously the Dodge Ram vans were the most popular, definitely. But they didn't make them in Class Cs. There was no such thing as a Dodge Class C motorhome after 1979, when they stopped making the cutaway vans. So the choice you had was Ford or Chevy. And I like them for lots of reasons. One, they don't change much. Number two, parts are cheap and available everywhere. Number three, anybody will work on them, even some guy in his backyard with a garage. Like, anybody can work on them because they're simple. And that Even this is getting a little too complex. I prefer less computers. I prefer carburetors. I prefer manual windows. I prefer everything mechanical, not software. The less computers, the better. I don't like everything being computerized, and I like parts to be readily available. And the nice thing about the Ford E-Series and the Dodge Ram vans is that most of the parts are interchangeable from year to year. And between the pickup lines, the F series for Ford and the Ram pickups for Dodge. A lot of the parts are the same. The engines are the same, the starters are the same, the brakes are the same, the wheels are the same, and the entire frame underneath the chassis is the same for the most part. Actually, the Dodge Ram vans are on the same platform as the Dodge Ram pickups, and I'm pretty sure it's the same with the Ford E series as well. So it's fantastic. If you ever need anything, you can go anywhere to your local Canadian Tire, to your local Lorco, or whatever auto parts store that you choose, and get parts cheap and the same day. Whereas with a Sprinter, you have to locate the parts, you have to pay out your behind for the parts compared to the North American equivalents, and then you have to find somebody that's actually willing to work on them. And that's one of the biggest problems the Sprinters have had breaking into the commercial market in North America, is that a lot of dealers, even Dodge dealers, which sold Sprinters for many years, a lot of them will not service or work on those vehicles. So if you're broken down in the middle of nowhere and you need a part, you're in a world of hurt. If you only rely on other people to look at and fix your vehicles, and you have the money to blow on it, go ahead and get a Sprinter or other Euro vans. Honestly, I'm not interested. I like to be able to open the hood and tinker and know you can fix things without having to bring it into a shop and have a computer replaced. And I actually have a friend of mine. He runs a medium-sized business. And he has six delivery vans, and he had all Econolines, all Ford Econoline vans. And when it came time to upgrade his vans, he replaced them with Sprinters. The leases on those Sprinters ran out last year, and he was swearing bloody murder about them. And he got rid of them all and went back to the Ford Econolines. Now that they're actually discontinued making the Econoline full-size vans. You can still get the Econoline motorhome chassis and cube vans, but the regular vans themselves, he got some of the last batch of them anyways. He wants to keep them as long as he can. The gas might be a little cheaper on a Sprinter, but the repair costs made up for that difference, plus some. He spent a lot more on those, and he couldn't handle the fact when they broke down, he had to get it towed to specialized dealers that would work on them. It's just such a pain in the butt. And when you're living this lifestyle, the last thing I worry about is gas mileage. I have a V10 in this and it kicks ass. I love it. I love it. I had a V8 in my Dodges before, and I always said if I could, I'd like to put a Hemi in one of my Dodge Ram vans. Having the power, the horsepower, and the torque, and being able to pass people on mountain highways, that to me is much more important. That and longevity, the fact that the engines can go a long time and repairs are cheap if you ever need any repairs. That stuff is way more important to me than miles per gallon or kilometers per liter. Like that, why am I going to be that cheap? I'm saving thousands of dollars already. I'm saving tens of thousands of dollars a year on rent and expenses compared to what I would be paying if I was renting an apartment and driving a car around. So I really don't care whether I'm getting a few miles per gallon less. That is irrelevant to me. That's my rent, all right? But I wouldn't trade it. I would not want a little engine in something that's hauling my house and all my water and all my propane and everything I own. I don't want some little V6 or some tiny little diesel to carry all that around. I want more power. That's just the way I am. I'm a muscle car guy. I like big, powerful muscle cars and big, awesome custom vans and pickup trucks. It's the kind of guy I am. And North American muscle. And one of the reasons I really like the Dodge Ram vans is because they're built right here in Canada. They're Canadian vehicles. And so I always have a bit of pride there, of course. But, there's a lot of globalization. Text. There's a lot of globalization with vehicles, so I mean there are apparently some Toyota models made in North America, in Canada and in the US, which are more North American than some Ford models because there's so much stuff made overseas now, and it's hard to tell what's North American and what's European and what's Japanese anymore because they're all so connected. And there's so many spin-offs of different models. Some of the new Chevy vans, the smaller delivery vans, are actually Nissan vans. They're just rebadged. So that being said, it's not so much about the brand loyalty. It's more about the mechanics. I like the fact that everything was engineered on this continent and parts are everywhere. Everywhere. And you can go to any shop anywhere to get anything done on it. Spur of the moment repairs, upgrades, whatever you need. And they're real trucks. When I see the Eurovans like Sprinters and the Ram Promasters and the new Ford Transit full-size vans, they look to me, they don't look like trucks anymore. They look like funky looking, really tall station wagons. I don't know, there's just something about them. Maybe it's the smaller wheels and the tiny engines in them, but it just turns me off. I wouldn't want to load that up with too much stuff. And I mean, the chassis on this thing has a higher GVWR than the Transit equivalent, the new Ford Transit. There's a reason they're still making the Econolines for motorhomes and cube vans and things like that. But I like big, tough, powerful vehicles and thick steel and big, heavy steel bumpers. I don't like crumple zones. I don't like plastic all over my vehicle. And I don't like software all over my vehicle. And that's what it really all comes down to. So hopefully that answers your question. All right, everyone, keep on rocking the free world.
Keep on rocking in the free world.
Keep on rocking.